The Goodspeed Opera House, located on the Connecticut River in East Haddam, is where people all over New England can enjoy their favorite off-Broadway musicals. Shows such as Annie Get Your Gun, Carnival, and How to Succeed in Business Without Really Trying have hit the Goodspeed stage. Built in 1876 by William H. Goodspeed, it was a theater, terminal for steamboat passengers, and even a general store. On October 24, 1877, the Goodspeed premiered its first show. The executive director, Michael Price, explains the history of this wonderful theater.
He's around here, and on the floor above us were a doctor's office, an insurance agency, and a real estate agency. And then the theater was on the top two floors. And by 1915, 1920, the building had fallen into disrepair, and the state of Connecticut was using it as a highway garage. About 1959, our then governor, Abraham Ribicoff, gave a group of antiquarians, or you might call them restoration people, history buffs, $10,000 to put a new roof on this building and to start restoring it. And they restored it as we know it today to be a working theater. The place has just grown into be a whole center of musical theater.
The opportunity to tour behind the scenes of the Goodspeed Opera House was a very memorable experience. Seeing the dressing rooms alone gave a lot of insight of how much work actually goes into a Goodspeed musical.
Goodspeed show cost a little over $1 million, maybe about $1.8 million.
Oh, I believe in you. I believe in you.
We audition in New York. We rehearse up here. We build the scenery and the costumes. We do the lighting here. We do all of the work on the show here in East Haddam and in Chester. We build from the ground up, putting all of the pieces together, new orchestrations, new dance arrangements, and it takes about 6 weeks of rehearsal and about 3 months of planning for each one of our productions.
They call us Groundhog. Groundhog. Groundhog.
Goodspeed actor Ron Carroll explains his theater through an actor's point of view.
Here at Goodspeed, they take older musicals or somewhat new and sometimes newer musicals, and they are confined to the space of the Goodspeed stage, which is really small by any standards. So whether you're playing in a little black box theater in some college that seats 200, or here at Goodspeed that seats 400, or on the road in a big auditorium that might seat 2,500, you're still directing for that physical space. So your direction, your acting, I mean, your performances are different in a place this size than it would be in a big, you know, drama outside or something.
The 10 month of the
Well, we received two Tony Awards. We received one for an outstanding regional theater, and we received a second one for the work we do in musical theater. And those, I think, are probably in the window right outside my office. Living in the Connecticut River Valley, we've got a lot to show. We've got beautiful settings in Haddam and East Haddam and Killingworth and in Chester, and it brings people here from all over the world. So we have a spectacular place, and this building being right on the river is just wonderful. Well, in 1 year, I don't see much change. We're growing. In 10 years, I think we'll have a short course university operation in place during the off season. We're building a lot of housing and dormitories, so we will have room for students in the off season. 100 years from now, I really don't know.
Somehow, the designers, the directors, choreographers make it look bigger, make it more opulent than you would think you would have in a production. And they usually have very good productions here.
I think it's that. One, to have a good time. Two, to support the work of writers and artists. It's real. It's real. It's real. It's real.